Hello and welcome to another live demo from Schildach in Germany. This time dedicated to the dairy industry. The format today is a little bit different as we are joined by the company Frisant Campina Kievit. And Kievit is part of the largest Dutch dairy processing company Frisant Campina and is specialized in the production of ingredients for the food industry. Yesterday we had the pleasure to talk to Mr. Grobbe from Frisant Campina. Unfortunately, he will not be able to join us today, so we will be playing the recording of the talk we had with him yesterday. My name is Rob Smulders, Business Development Manager from Vega in the Netherlands, and with me here is Holger Sack from Vega, Germany.
Thanks, Rob. Hello, everybody, also from my side, and welcome to our live demo. I'm Holger Sack, Head of Product Management here at Vega in Schildach. I'm working for Vega for more than 30 years now. Today we want to provide you in the next 30 minutes interesting information about our solution in your market. So let's start for today.
First of all, I would like to thank you, Marcel, for joining us in this webinar. Could you please introduce yourself and the company Frisant Campina and especially the Kievit site?
Thank you. Yes, I'm glad to do that. So my name is Marcel Grobbe. I work for Frisant Campina Kievit in Meppel. I've been working for Frisant Campina now for about 25 years.
And you sent us a really nice video, which we will start first, and then you can explain us about the company Kievit.
40% of all land on Earth is covered with grass. For us, it's the start of everything we do. Deeply rooted within Dutch soil, but also in a rich history of collaboration, innovation, and sustainability, Friesland Campina makes food that is nutritious and tasty. Friesland Campina is one of the largest cooperatives worldwide with over 18,000 member farmers. Our goal to provide better nutrition and a good living for our farmers goes hand in hand with making sure we produce products in a sustainable way. Innovation is one of our top priorities so that we can always provide the highest quality in our products. A growing world population and increasing wealth mean a higher demand for food. We are at the forefront of ensuring quality nutrition for the next generation. Our history has led to 140 years of experience, with branches in 34 countries and over 23,000 employees worldwide. We export our products to over 100 countries and share a total revenue of 12 billion euros. And we keep focused on what we know is most important.
Nice video from Frisant Campina. And I think you can tell us a little bit more about the company, Marcel.
Yes, of course, a lot have been said in the video, but I like to tell something more. Can you go to the next slide? As you can see on the slide, we are owned by about 17,000 farmers and about 11,000 farms. The main purpose of our company, it's already been told also in the movie, but it's nourishing by nature. So we want to provide better nutrition for the world. Of course, we want to do that in a sustainable way. So we want a good living for the farmers now, but also for the futures and generations to come. On this slide, you see some of our brands. Very famous within Friesland Campina is, for example, Friso for the baby food, but also Frisian Flag, Campina, a really big brand, and also, for example, Dutch Lady, but there are many more. At the right side, you see also the top ingredients. One of them is our Fana Grasa that's being produced at my company, Kievit in Meppel. That's a soup creamer. But within my company, we make a lot of ingredients for a lot of industries. So we make it for soups, we make it for sauces, we make it for bakery, but also ingredients for example, baby food. Another big product is toppings that's used in bakery. In this slide, you can see where we are positioned. So the headquarters of our company are based in Amersfoort. Our R&D center is in Wageningen, and my working company is situated in Meppel. But other Kievit companies, Kievit plants, factories, are in Salatiga in Indonesia and also in Germany in Liebstadt. And what you can also see in this picture that we have plants and offices all around the world. So it's totally global. What you see here is our plant in Meppel. So this is where I'm working. The first building are the offices, and the high buildings in the background are the factory with a total of four dryer machines. Then here a little bit about the dryers. In Meppel, we have three FilterMet dryers and one conventional dryer. The FilterMet dryer is a special machine. After we prepare the emulsion in the emulsion line, we pump it under high pressure to the nozzles situated inside of the dryer. The first drying is being done in the primary drying chamber. After that, the product falls on a belt. That's why it's called FilterMat. It's a filter belt. The belt has a double function. The first product is going to lay on that belt, and the belt distinguishes the air and filters the air from the product. And the last, if you go to the right, you see also the possibility for drying and cooling the product. And in the last section of the FilterMat dryer, the product falls we call it in Dutch the achterbak. It's a trough, and after that we have the rest of the dry processing and the packaging. In the right picture, you see a conventional dryer. In this dryer, the main drying is being done in a big cylinder, and after that the last drying and cooling is being done in an external fluid bed. And after that, we have the rest of the powder handling and the packaging.
Cool, nice. Thank you for this introduction, Marcel. For this session, we would like to focus on three applications within Friesland Campina, all three with a different measuring principle. We're going to speak about radar level measurement. We're going to speak about a level switch, but we want to start with a pressure measurement.
Yes. At first, we would like to speak about an application which you find in many dairy factories, and this is pump pressure monitoring. In this case, this pump pressure monitoring is used to monitor filter conditions. So if the pressure drops down behind the filter, it indicates that that filter is polluted and you have to start cleaning process. The application sounds simple, but it isn't, because if there is a failure measurement or if the sensor breaks, then it can result in a huge effort, time and cost consuming to clean or to fix that application. We have here a small animation of that kind of application. This is a cheese factory, and here we show how this is working. You see the besang for the cheese production and the mixture, and during that process the liquid gets down, filtered by this equipment and those devices monitoring the pressure of the pumps inside the pipes and indicates any pollution if cleaning needs to be started or not.
Yes, and this is the application as installed at Friesland Campina Kievit. Friesland Campina Kievit was one of the first companies in the Netherlands which participated with Vega in the field tests of our new pressure devices. In this case, a Vega Bar 38 pressure device. What's really nice about this device is that you have a really big screen on which you can both read, of course, the pressure which the sensor measures, but also to set up the device via the three push buttons on the screen. A second thing is, and it's not lit at this device, but Holger will show us in a second, is a LED LED light indication on the device, which you can set up as you want for even five different pressure modes. So for instance, if the pressure is running within specification, you can have a green light. When it's, well, not fully within specification, but it's not a real big problem, you make it orange. And when there's a failure, for example, you make it red. And you can see this indication from quite a big distance, which I think, Holger, you can show on the demo device which we have over
here. Yes, of course. Here you see such a Vigabath 38 indicates green on the LED ring, which is visible more or less 360 degrees around that application. And this is a real sensor working, and we can simulate the pressure. And if the pressure goes above a certain value, in this case programmed here, the green light turns from green to purple. You can decide what color you would like to indicate, what color you want to have. We have up to 256 possibilities for that colors here. You can use your standard values as well as your special values. And you can do this, as Rob already said, with the on-site adjustment tools or via the app adjustment possibilities. One special thing for the Vigabath 38 is the ceramic cell. And because, you know, in many applications of your market, you use a metal cell. But here, the big advantage of a ceramic cell is the resistance against pressure shocks in the pipe, in the vessel, and against abrasion caused by the product itself or by solids inside the product.
Thank you. And that can be positive as well as negative pressure shocks.
Sure.
I think that's a nice feature. Thank you. The second one is a level measurement. Within Friesland Campina Kievit, we have installed several level measurement, and I think we have a really nice pictures of the silo park. Marcel, can you tell us something about your bulk silos?
Yes, what you see here is our P&ID of our end product silos of Dryer 1. Dryer 1 is our conventional dryer. And we have the possibility to, with pneumatic conveying, to get the product into those six silos. What's lifted out here is the standard configuration on top of the silo. So you see a filling line. We have a over and under pressure relief valve. You see also the filter. That's to filter the product from the pneumatic air. And you see level transmitters. So in the past, we only had a level detector, a level switch. So we only knew that it was full. But about 50 years ago, we decided to put in the level transmitter, the radar level transmitter of Vega. So we have been using that now for about 50 years. And this next picture, you can see the top of the silos. And you see the filling lines, the over under pressure relief valve, also the filters. And you also see the yellow heads of the Vega radar level transmitters.
Thank you, Marcel. And why do we find this a very interesting application if we installed the radar sensors 15 years ago? Well, 15 years ago, we started with this radar sensor, but there have been quite a lot of changes since then. But perhaps it's a good idea, Holger, to first explain radar technology in basics.
Of course, thank you. The general principle of radar as a non-contact measurement principle is that the system generates a microwave signal, which is transmitted from the antenna downwards to the surface of the product and then reflected by the product and received by the system again. The time between transmitting and receiving is corresponding to the distance between the sensor and the surface of the product. And if you know the height of the vessel, the height of the application, you can calculate or corresponds direct to the level of your product. There are two features which are important for a reliable measurement. First is the signal beam of a radar device, and second is the dynamic range. The signal beam is important for the surface of the product to be seen by the sensor, or important how many disturbing echoes the system is seeing. That means the smaller that beam is, the less disturbing signals the sensor gets from the vessel itself, from obstacles inside, from any disturbing things, and the better the measurement is. And to demonstrate how this is looking like, for example, for a 26 gigahertz sensor, which has also influence of the beam, we have presented here a footprint of a vessel or of an application where the sensor is 3 meters above the application. And this is the area what the sensor is seeing working with 26 gigahertz. We have also here a new sensor, VegaPulse 69, working with 80 gigahertz. And this sensor has a much higher frequency, and therefore the signal beam is much smaller than on lower frequencies. We demonstrate this here with this Frisbee disc. And at the same conditions with 3 meter distance between the sensor or the top of the vessel and the product, the footprint is only that small, what means the sensor is more reliable because less disturbing echoes are visible and can work much better and causes less problems. The dynamic range I mentioned as second point is the capability of a radar sensor to see also very small signals. You can imagine if you have a surface of liquid, it acts like a mirror and you get 100% back of your energy. On solids, where you have angle of response on different products, powders, granulates, you get less energy back reflected from the surface. And that means only a very small portion of the energy will be received by the sensor. And the higher dynamic range is, the smaller the signals can be. That means the more reliable a sensor is working on that application.
Yes, and next to the dynamic range, one of the things that is really important is the product which you want to measure. And that's something that Frisson Campina has done a lot of work in continuously developing new products. And Marcel, I think you can tell us something about product development within Frisson Campina Kivit.
Yes. It's not only product development, it's also from the beginning on it was very challenging to measure the level in the silos, because we make a lot of different products on that dryer. One of the main difficulties was to measure we call it a cappuccino foamer. So that's a powder with a bulk density below 200 grams per liter. So that was always a big a challenge to measure that product. But over the years, it got more difficult because our new product development department evolves and changes products, of course. One of the development is to make it more healthy. So unhealthy fats are being replaced by better fats. Also, another trend is, for example, protein-free. So those are developments that make our product different in the years.
Yeah, that makes our level measurement even more challenging. And that's something which we saw. We started with these level measurements, as Marcel stated, 15 years ago. And after, I think, 5 or 6 years, we saw that it was getting more and more difficult for the first sensors to distinguish a product from the echo which you get back from the product. So at that time, we developed a new electronic insert, because there's an electronic in here with a higher dynamic range. And with that new electronic, we were able to measure with the same device, which Holger just had there, to create a reliable measurement. But with continuous development at Frisson Campina, we saw that even that didn't work anymore. So we installed the new VegaPulse 69, so the 80 gigahertz radar sensor with an even higher dynamic range. And since then, the level measurement has been working fine without any big problems. So the last application we would like to discuss is a project on which Marcel did a lot of work on. It's a tumbling sifter. Marcel, could you please explain the process from this application?
Yes, the project started out with the question just to replace the old sifter, it's a gyratory sifter, by a new tumbler sifter. But to do that, we had to change the complete powder handling after the dryer. So what you see here is the new configuration. At the red dot, you see that's the last section of our filter mud dryer. There the product comes out of our dryer to gain height again, because there was a lack of height in the factory. To gain height again, we had a new ascending conveyor. After the conveyor, you see a lump breaker followed by a conveyor. Next slide, please. Yeah, in the next slide, you see the new sifter. It's a tumbler sifter. It works as a police sifter. So the sifted product, the good product, is going to the packaging department, and the oversized product is going to the oversized product big bag. What you also see is here, after the product outlet, a rotary magnet. And yeah, why did we place a lot of level switches of Vega? In the past, we sometimes had a failure or a hiccup in production. And then we buffered our product in the last section of the dryer. After the problem was solved, we had a lot of powder and a high powder flow, higher than normal, and that could cause that our installation ran full of powder. And when you have the situation that you go from one conveyor to the next conveyor, but it's completely full, you have the chance that the inside of the conveyor is damaged. The same is also when you have, for example, a blockage in your sifter. When you keep conveying the powder inside of the blocked machine, it's logical that the machines will break down. So that's why we installed six Vega level switches to avoid these types of problems.
Okay, thank you. Really nice application. We have one of those level switches over here, the Vega point with the green LED at the moment. And when I cover the tip, you see it switches from green to red, that it is covered. And one of the important things for Friesland Campina is that it is really easy to adjust the sensor to the product in which it measures. We have some of the product here from Friesland Campina. It's a topping which they produce at the site in Meppel. And Holger, I think you can show how easy it is to set up the device for this product.
Okay, this is the standard setting of the device we deliver to all of our customers. And we think that 90% of all applications are, this setting is fine. But we will see that this setting is not good enough for this application, for this powder. You see the sensor is not switching, and therefore you need to address this special conditions, which is very easy. You have to connect to the Bluetooth tool you are using or you want to use, a tablet or iPhone, and just go to application, and instead of standard application, choose the user-defined application and press OK. And now you have the possibility to adjust uncovered or covered mode. Adjustment with medium. And let's say this is the uncovered mode now. You tell the sensor this is uncovered. And afterwards, you bring the sensor in contact with the product, which is the covered mode. And afterwards, you need to download all the settings, and the system knows and can switch now reliable with this product, which is very easy and done by less than 1 minute.
Marcel, you also told us in our discussions that you spend a lot of time optimizing the process connection for the Vega point in your application. Could you please tell us something more about that?
Yes, I can. Here you see the process connection that we first used. This is the Varivent male part of the connection. Especially in our application, we have falling powders. So we install the Vega level switch in a vertical pipe. what we saw is that with the female part, so the welding part that was inside of the pipe, this was not totally flush. So what we saw is that with just a little bit of deposit because of the dust of the falling powder, just a little bit of residue in the last part of the last furrow causes a detection of the powder, which we didn't like and we would not want, of course. So what we did then is to use this welding connection, and we put it inside of the wall, but not flush, but we put it in even deeper. So if you get deposits then of dust, it will be around on the Las Ferule, and it will not detect the powder. Another thing we did is to put it under an angle, so the powder has a chance to fall off. So after these optimizations, it worked satisfactory.
Okay, really nice. And Holger, I think you can show us something about the different process connections for the Vega Point or Vega Bar.
This is the connection Marcel just mentioned, the Varivent connection, and we have designed all the devices, not only the Vega Point, the level switch sensors, also the Vega Bar, the pressure sensors, that way that you can use standard adapters for hygienic application. You just need to use this 1-inch thread connection of the sensor, and then you can easily screw it into the adapter. And those type of adapters are available for different type of typical hygienic connection, which is, for example, here a tri-clamp connector, and other weld-in adapters are also available. So that makes the system very flexible for you as a user and keeps the stock very low, because you just need to have the adapter specialized for your application and can use more or less a standard device for all of the different vessels you have.
Thank you. Yes. So this already brings us to the end of the applications. Marcel, a final word to you. Do you have something to add to the presentation?
Yes, one of our the main reasons why we chose for Vega, for the Vega level switch, was the it was best of class when we tested. If you look at the how sensible it is. But what was also a big plus for this one is the Bluetooth connection. So we could, you can change the settings. You can set it up without even during production. So the machines can still turn, and we can get the right settings into the device.
Okay, cool. Thank you. So I would like to thank you for participating in this webinar, and hopefully we'll see you in the webinars which will come afterwards.
Thank you very much also from my side for your valued time to attend, and hopefully see you again in the near future.